The predicted shape of the financial services sector in Africa is a market without boundaries, accessible to most, if not all, and technology-driven. Now, I attended this year's DotFinance Africa Conference in Nairobi, and the future of financial services in Africa was among the key conversations. Take a look. Over the last decade, penetration in mobile smart devices and the internet have transformed financial services from brick and mortar to virtual platforms across Africa. This disruption has placed the continent's financial space at an unprecedented stage, and banks have to continually rethink their strategies.
When we look at banking and we look at the services we provide, they have to be embedded in the lifestyles of our customers in a way that helps them achieve whatever it is they want to achieve at that particular point in time. And that is a fair challenge, because it's more around the psyche of the people, and the technology enables you to go and do that. So when we're thinking about it, that's how we're trying to unpack this, by working with the customers themselves. And then we work backwards to what technology will help us, you know, do that. So mobile is the obvious one today.
MNOs are facilitating payment systems to an extent, but banks continue to play in that space as they've traditionally done. What they need to do is to ensure that they keep up with the pace. They keep up with how fast the MNOs have distinguished themselves as being very fast innovators, moving very fast, you know, investing in technology and so on. Banks need to choose on either becoming or continuing to be followers or to be shapers of the future. Being able to shape the future means they need to move along with these MNOs, being able to invest in the research, in innovations, so as to come up with innovative ways, novel, new ways, taking into account all of the things that are happening, to be able to continue to be relevant.
For banks, it has been a race towards expanding service provision on digital platforms with a keen focus on facilitating payments. For instance, a 2014 report by McKinsey says that about 86% of Kenyan households use mobile-based solutions for their payments.
It is as fast as cash, which is actually the key driving force that's moving people to mobile financial services. So that has not been a problem. But where the threats are, so that's the national safety that we have. But we also have external threats coming in. So you have the PayPal coming to Nigeria. You have people who are opening wallets with Amazon and also Google as well. So for us as an organization, we see our business as, so we are building this platform that provides a service infrastructure for people, and where banking is one of the services that we offer, and we are partnering with other organizations to actually offer value to the customers in our ecosystem.
It's easy to think that our customers are already digitally educated and enabled. In practice, it's much more complex. And rolling out a very attractive product, for instance, free current account with free mobile banking transactions, you could imagine that it would be a self-selling product, but actually you still need to spend a lot of time with each customer to educate the customer, with each agent, and which even starting from staff, actually. The very first challenge we face in digital disruption is change management with staff.
Telecommunication companies and other stakeholders in the innovation space have taken the lead in disruption of financial services in Kenya and elsewhere across Africa. While the immediate feeling was that financial institutions were being pushed out of the market, banks have now found a way to coexist with the incoming innovations.
The idea that somehow telcos want to become banks, I think it'll be crazy. You know, if you look at the banks and saying, I have a balance sheet, I have a regulatory issues, I have low margins, profit dropping, why want to be a bank? Well, they're not interested in a bank. They're interested in figuring out how to retain their customers, how to give more profit to customers, how to really have more RPU per customer, right? So that's what they're thinking about. I think where people have to start playing is, in the middle of it, what kind of services do they provide? If banks think that their infrastructure and the platforms, the applications, the software they have, is from the dark ages, right? So it's not good enough. So get out of the mindset that somehow you have a better product than the other folks out there, right?
Banks are going to be fostering, forming a lot more partnerships with the MNOs, with the startups, the fintechs that have been developed. All that will be by way of ensuring that we address the changing needs of the customers that we currently have. All that will be to ensure that we continue to serve the people we've been serving, because a lot of new things are being thrown at them. And that if we don't move at the same pace, then banks will lose their footing. And the only way to do that is to ensure that we move as fast, be as innovative as we can be, invest in new ways of doing things, and form very good partnerships.
So far, financial institutions have registered lower cost of operations driven by the shift from brick and mortar platforms. Going forward, banks plan to stay on the lookout for innovations that will change the banking sector.
The reduction in price of smartphones and penetration of smartphones or smart devices and getting them into the hands of more people is going to be a drastic transformation, because you will be able to then do a lot more through various applications which could be developed anywhere in the world. So I think that's going to be quite a game changer. And the fact that is, those devices will be so close to people's lives and interwoven in everything they do. I mean, we talked about smart cars and smart refrigerators and everything. And I think we have to figure out how those smart devices enable people to get more out of life.
So one of the features I see in the tool in the near future is that you get access to services without any efforts. If you take the example of Uber, for instance, you get into a car, you move where you want to go, and you never pay. You never have to act on paying. And that's exactly where we need to go. We need to get digital services where customers, merchants interact and agree without doing the effort of paying, taking out the cash or whatever, the credit card, etc.